Have you ever thought about, or wanted actually, to give a TED Talk? Hi, I'm Mary Morrissey. I'm the author of two best-selling books, No Less Than Greatness and Building Your Field of Dreams, which became a PBS special. I was invited to give a TEDx Talk, and the journey between the invitation and the delivery of that talk and what I learned afterwards is what this video is about. So it's a personal journey inside my own inner world of my experience in designing and delivering a TEDx talk, and then the reflection on that over time and what it's meant to me. TED invites you, when you give a TEDx talk or a TED talk, to give one big idea. What's your one big idea? So I was invited and I said yes, and I was thrilled and happy, and then there's time between the invitation and the delivery, and I'm to design an 18-minute talk, was my invitation, and it has to all be built around my one big idea. I've been in transformation for over 40 years, helping people design and deliver lives they love living. I know a whole system of transformation that moves people from where they are to where they want to be, but one big idea. So to try to take 40 years and bring it down to all the different things I could have talked about, and then to pick the one that I really want to bring alive inside this talk. So if someone said to you, what's your one big idea? What's your one big idea? If you could share one thing with the world, what would you love to share with the world? And that's a really lovely part of being invited to do this kind of talk, or something. It's lovely to actually ask yourself that, because ultimately when we know what's our one big idea, it helps us make sure we're giving that and living into that more often. For me, it was the idea that there is an invisible side of success, that there's a pattern by which success occurs. And I use the Thoreau code, or the Thoreau quote around if one advances confidently in the direction of their dream, to show a through line between someone wanting to have change and someone actually having change. I decided to weave in my own personal story for the purpose of showing someone moving and transforming their life from one state. For me, it was laying in a hospital bed being told I wasn't going to live, to actually living a full life with great health over many, many decades, by means of a transformational process. So what's your one big idea if you were to share on a TED stage that you would love for the world to have? For me, it was there is an inner pattern for success. If you want outer success, then here's an inner pattern that you can replicate that'll assure, certainly make welcome, a kind of success that really matters to you. The second thing I learned is once I got on that stage, that I knew that 18 minutes was gonna go fast, and I'd rehearsed it and repeated it. But I found, if upon reflection, I talked really fast during that time. If I'm sharing with someone what you could learn from my own experiences, slow down. Slow down. Let yourself feel the message while you're giving it. If you rehearse the talk, you can know where you're going to be in the flow of the minutes. But I got on that stage, and something shifted in me, and I talked faster than I think I've ever talked in any talk I've ever given. So have your message, rehearse it, of course, but once you're on the stage, if you're like me, then having a message to say, just slow down, feel your message while you're giving it, not just get through the words. And number three, the thing I've learned over many, many decades, actually, of being on all kinds of different stages, is before you go on stage and you take a deep breath, remind yourself to get your attention off yourself, that this is not about you, it's really about the message that can make a difference in the person's life. Why you've gone to all this trouble to practice a talk, why you've taken your one big thing you want to communicate to the world, why it is that you probably, for many of us, for me, I traveled across the country to deliver the TED Talk, that you put yourself in that environment is because there's something that has mattered and made a difference to you, and you care about delivering that in a way that it can impact and influence and bring good to someone else. When you get your attention off yourself and you put it on making an impact in the audience's lives, one person at a time, there's another energy that happens, and something moves through that's really beyond what any of us can do on our own. So whenever you're giving a message, pour your heart into the message, really desiring and focusing on the person you're giving it to, that they might really hear that message and benefit by means of it. So number one, what's your big idea? Number two, when you're delivering it, slow down. And number three, take your attention off yourself and put it on the person you're sharing it with, that you might really impact them in a way that can help them. So if you've enjoyed this video, then please share it. Go ahead, subscribe to our YouTube channel if you haven't done that already. And here's a question for you. What's an insight or a breakthrough that opened up for you as a result of watching this video? What does it mean to your speaking? What does it mean to what you're going to bring did you come up with your one big idea? And go ahead and share your thoughts here with me. I'd love to hear from you. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you real soon. Bye for now.